Hey YouTube, it's Natalie. Hope you're doing well. This is just gonna be a really quick video. I'm not gonna be doing a lot of inserts I'm not gonna be doing a lot of inserts or editing or anything like that. I just wanted to give some quick thoughts on the Ted Cruz taking a trip to Cancun during the massive storm that Texas had, which caused a lot of damage. I have some friends that live in Texas. I will put in the description bar down below some resources if you want to help people in Texas, like mutual aids and things like that. If you want to reach out and offer financial assistance. So basically what happened is Texas saw its first snowstorm since the 90s. It affected places like San Antonio, Houston, Austin, like just all over the state. They were, and you know, it's a massive state. A lot of people live there. And what basically happened is that they got snow, they got below freezing temperatures, which obviously is not the norm for Texas. So, you know, I'm not going to make that like a political thing, that they don't have the infrastructure set up to deal with weather like that. I don't think that even needs to be political. I don't know if like, if you're like in an inland state, for example, and they just somehow got flooding, obviously they wouldn't have the infrastructure set up for that. There are some questions about, you know, the source of energy, then the power grid being cut off from the rest of the country and being completely privatized. And then was it wind turbines that shut down? And wind turbines are only, I think, 20% of the source of energy. Everything else comes from, you know, coal and oil and stuff like that. So, you know, there are environmental implications that I am not qualified to speak about because I'm not an environmentalist. I'm an attorney. I'm not as well versed on those particular issues. I just like, you know, try to recycle and try to use reusable water bottles. You know, like really, I am not well versed on the issue of climate change and how it impacts the environment. All that I know is that I try to be as personally conscious as possible. And I do believe, based on the research that I've seen, that the climate is being impacted by man-made pollution and stuff like that. But other than that, you know, they had a massive weather event, right? That is not the fault of the everyday people of Texas. It's not the fault of the leaders of Texas that they had a massive weather event, in my opinion. I don't think that that's really like anyone's fault. It's about the response. Like, how do you respond to the thing that is happening, right? And like, the thing I didn't like about the situation was that people were almost attacking Texans themselves. Like, oh, if you didn't vote for Republicans, then this will be happening. And like, that's what people said to New Yorkers during Hurricane Sandy, when that was like tearing up the Northeast. And people were like, oh, well, if you had better Democratic infrastructure, then you guys wouldn't be so like unprepared for these floods and stuff. And it's just like, you know, the weather is just not like what it used to be. Areas are not prepared for it. We should get prepared for it. And that is up to our leaders, but both Democrats and Republicans are guilty of not doing what needs to be done in order to prepare for climate change, right? So again, that's not really like what my issue is, just to be clear. And I don't think that you should blame the people of Texas, because although yes, Texas does go Republican for like, you know, the presidential election, the Senate races and things like that, but like for like House races, mayoral races, they go Democratic sometimes. And it doesn't matter, Democrat, Republican, these are all human beings that like, you know, had their houses flooded, they were without food. Like, that's what I want to make clear. Like, it's not, I'm not saying like, oh, if it was a Republican state, they would deserve for people to talk about them like that. They don't deserve for people to talk about them like that in the midst of like trying to figure out like where their next meal is going to come from. People have died. I think that because they've never dealt with the cold before, some people didn't know that like if you sit in your garage and run your car, that you could die from carbon monoxide poisoning. A few people died like that. Like, they ran their cars in their garage to try to like get some heat and then ended up poisoning themselves and dying. A child died like froze like of hypothermia and stuff. So it's really, really sad what's happening. Well, in the midst of all that crazy stuff that is going on, I think it was like day three of the crisis. People were without power. People were without water. Their pipes had burst. People's houses were flooded. People were frozen in, you know, no water. Ted Cruz and his wife, Heidi, and their two daughters, and their children, let's just put it that way, decide to take a trip to Cancun, Mexico. And it's pretty hush-hush, but it's like Ted Cruz and his wife and their neighbors, you know, they're like friends. Let's not forget that they are in the middle of a Panasonic. So we don't know, like, you know, if it's like really safe to be traveling right now. Some people are traveling for pleasure, not for me personally, but some people are currently traveling for pleasure. And they decided to take a trip to Cancun, Mexico. The issue is that Ted Cruz is the junior senator from the state of Texas. So while his state is in the midst of this crisis, he is the junior senator from Texas. And so you would think he would stay in the state instead of, you know, traveling to Cancun. It goes pretty okay for him until people spot him in the airport. And he's, it's not funny. Like, it's not funny, but like, I like have to laugh at like the ridiculousness of, you don't think this is a social media age. So people film him in the airport with his kids and his wife getting ready to fly off to Cancun. He apparently, now that we know more, had tickets to come back to the U.S. on the Saturday. So they were like leaving on like a Wednesday, and then they were supposed to come back on Saturday. So, but once it hit the media, Ted Cruz turned his flight around and came back, you know, at 6 a.m. and then booked his flight to come right back. So his first story was that he was just, his daughters were, you know, having cabin fever, and they were locked in the house, and they had lost power, and everyone was cold. And they said, "Dad, can we just take a trip?" And so he was just chaperoning the daughters on the trip. And what's funny about that is that you're making it seem as though it's your daughter's, like, you know, fault, basically. Like, it's, oh, my girls, they wanted to take a trip, so I had to acquiesce. And it's just like, you know, you're a parent, so you can just easily say, now's not a good time since I'm the junior senator of the state that's in the midst of a crisis and we're in a panorama, and I don't want to, you know, potentially, you know, look bad, and I want to stay here and I want to help, you know, my constituents, and you're the parent and you can put your foot down. So people weren't buying that story. Well, he held on to it for a little while, and then the group chat with the friends, between Heidi and, you know, their friends, basically where Heidi was planning the trip, like, "Hey guys, it's cold, let's get out of here, I want to go to Mexico," and it doesn't have anything to do with the daughters and what the daughters wanted. It was the adult's decision. Of course it was the adult's decision to go to Mexico. And there's a lot of irony there with going to Mexico that I'm not going to get into. There's a lot of irony there, but you know, then Ted Cruz came clean. Some people were trying to say that it wasn't even him, but he had to admit that it was him. So he, you know, flew back. He came clean. He said that, you know, he knows that it looks bad. While he was giving the speech about how he knows it looks bad, he's sorry about it, but, you know, he just wanted to take a trip, and he was going to work from Cancun. People were yelling at him, like, from behind the bushes to resign. So that wasn't good. So, like, optics-wise, it was really, really bad. The issue that I wanted to address with all of that buildup was this. A couple of social media commentators and conservative journalists and media personalities have, I think, in an attempt to downplay the seriousness, because Ted Cruz is a conservative, but also maybe to save face or whatever the case may be, they're trying to help him out, right? So media is biased nowadays. Like, we try, like, you know, Governor Cuomo in New York, he's having a scandal right now. And the liberal media can be accused of trying to cover for him. And so I think the conservative media was trying to cover for Ted Cruz. So they were basically saying, like, look, what could he do? He's the senator, you know, he's not the governor. It was funny because Donald Trump Jr. said, the governor of, you know, like, why doesn't the Democratic governor do something instead of attacking the Republican senator? And it was like, the governor of Texas is Greg Abbott, and he's a Republican. So that point doesn't make any sense. It shouldn't even be a bipartisan thing. But what they were saying in order to defend Ted Cruz for his blunder. I think even he admitted it was a blunder. It's a blunder. You know, it's not something you should have done. It was a bad idea. The optics were terrible. But what they were saying was, oh, what can he do? He's only the junior senator from Texas, right? He's not the governor. He's not the mayor of these multiple places. He can't issue the National Guard. He can't send out FEMA. What can he do? Well, I did want to give you guys an example of having lived in a state during a disaster. I lived in New York during 9/11. And aside from it being, of course, a very, very horrible event, it was a event in which our leadership, which is bipartisan in New York, a lot of times you have like Republicans in charge at some point, Democrats in charge at others. We had a trifecta of bipartisan or tripartisan leadership. We had, at the very time that it happened, we had, Rudy Giuliani, who is a Republican. Hillary Clinton was the junior senator. She is a Democrat. Then we had Mike Bloomberg take over, and Mike Bloomberg was formerly a Republican and then became an independent and then became a Democrat later when he wanted to run for president. Rudy Giuliani is not my favorite person. Mike Bloomberg, not my favorite person, like, at all. And I did not vote for Hillary Clinton when she ran to be the senator from New York because I thought she was a carpetbagger. But they came together. They all marshaled resources together. Hillary Clinton toured, you know, different locations. She made sure that people got the support that they needed in DC into New York. And of course, no one was going to give her pushback. Like, I'm sure no one would give Ted Cruz pushback because it was a disaster. It was an attack, you know, and it was horrible. And there was a consensus that we should all come together. I don't know if we've had the ability to come together like that since then without something being so politicized. Maybe it was because the enemy was outside, you know, because it was a foreign enemy. But for some reason, we just haven't had the ability to come together like that. But be that as it may, they have completely Republican leadership. So it's not like they should be infighting with each other or like Ted Cruz can't get them resources. But there are certainly things that he could be doing. Like what was done during 9/11, like what was done during Hurricane Sandy, where, you know, the governor came together, the mayor came together, you know, there are ways in which, senators, can participate and help with relief to their states, right? And that has been made glaringly obvious by the fact that senators and, Congress people from other states have been pitching in with Texas. So I just would like for us to, I'm gonna, you know, conclude this video. This is not really a legal analysis of what's going on. It's more of like a common sense analysis. When you make a mistake, we all make mistakes, right? Ted Cruz is made a mistake in that situation where he left the state that he is governing, that he represents, that he is supposed to, when writing laws, advocate for those people. He left the state. He should not have done that, right? That was a bad thing to do. It's just really, there's no question about it. And even if that's your favorite party or your favorite senator, you don't need to excuse the behavior, even though it is like, it is almost like the knee-jerk thing to want to do that, right? There are people from my party who have done things where I know it sucks. I know it sucks because Democrats have done some crappy stuff. And for me to have to like defend them doing those crappy things, I can't do it. You know, sometimes it's okay to say, you know what, this is the party I prefer to vote for whatever reason. I'm a fiscal conservative. I believe in Christian values and I am anti-choice, you know, or whatever the case may be, right? You have different political opinions than what I have. It does not mean that you have to allow these media outlets to check your common sense at the door, right? Obviously, it's not a good idea to leave the state. And just practically speaking, as a matter of the function of government, it's a really, really bad idea to leave your state when they're in the midst of a natural disaster, when you are a sitting politician. Because he got a police escort into the airport. He got a police escort out of the airport. People are calling for emergency services right now and unable to get through because, you know, they're overwhelmed. And so you're diverting police resources away from people that are in need You know, houses were burning and the fire department just had to leave them to burn because they didn't have any water. I mean, it's really, really bad what's going on there. So it's just inconsiderate of your fellow Texans, inconsiderate of your fellow human beings. And I'm not going to be hypocritical and sit up here and be like, I'm so disappointed in Ted Cruz, because it's not like, you know, I was checking for Ted Cruz anyway, or like I liked Ted Cruz. I'm not going to pretend that, you know, I'm not going to sit here and say, oh, I'm completely unbiased. I'm not unbiased. I don't like Ted Cruz, right? But I didn't like Rudy Giuliani either. I don't like him now. But when he was the mayor of New York post 9/11, he did the daggone thing when it came to being the mayor of New York. And that's why he stood a decent chance in the very beginning when he first ran for president. He did a really, really good job. I don't like Mike Bloomberg. Our recovery after 9/11 was mostly due to the efforts of Mike Bloomberg. He did a great job. He really, really did, you know? So there can be people that you don't like, but you can step aside and say, you know what? I like what you did here. I live in a state with a Republican governor, Larry Hogan. I am not a Republican. I did not vote for Larry Hogan both times that he was up for election. I wanted a Democrat, right? But as far as the panorama is concerned, panorama, I know you don't like it, panorama. As far as the panorama is concerned, he's done a great job, in my opinion. Not perfect. I know some people want schools closed. Some people want schools opened. I don't have a kid in school, so I don't have a dog in that fight. But he's done a pretty decent job, you know, as far as making sure that the numbers stay relatively low. We have a lot of international people coming into the state. So people going from you know, one country to the next, where the risk is really, really high of different variants of, you know, the strain of the virus. And he's done like a pretty good job, you know, as far as keeping everybody safe is concerned. And obviously my support of that is conditional on him continuing to do a good job, but he's done pretty well. You know, he lowered like the toll on the Chesapeake Bay Bridge, which was like ridiculously expensive. And for a while I had to take that bridge every single day, and I was into that, you know, I liked it, you know? Definitely in his second term, I think that he's been pretty good as far as I'm concerned. And so this could have been Ted Cruz's moment where, and maybe he doesn't care. It doesn't matter. Like, maybe he doesn't care what someone like me says, because he's probably going to say like, oh, well, you're not going to vote for a Republican. But if Larry Hogan was going to run again, you know, obviously he can't, you know, it's two terms. But if he was going to run again, based on his performance this term, I would vote for him because he's done a pretty good job as far as I'm concerned, right? So this could have been Ted Cruz's moment where he stepped up to the table and everybody was like, you know what? Doesn't matter what I thought about Ted Cruz, he has really pulled through for the people of Texas. Hopefully he will learn from this and be more hands-on with helping his constituents. And we'll see, you know, hope springs eternal. But anyway, those are my thoughts on the Ted Cruz situation and the terrible storm that has hit Texas and the aftermath of that storm. Let me know what you guys think in the comment section down below. Again, I am going to be sharing resources in the description bar down below for anyone that wants to do any type of donation. I think I know that I'm also going to be doing a donation on Monday for Texas Relief. They have a long road ahead of them. You guys take care of yourselves, and I'll talk to you later. Bye.